Ervin in lane four. One length of the pool. Below him is Adrian.
Boy, I had my eye on that start for Ervin, and each time he's gotten better. That's what he needed. I think if he had a good start, he might be able to punch his ticket to London.
Look at Colin Jones up in lane two, second from the top. Ervin's trying to battle back to below him in lane four. It is Jones up top in lane two. Adrian's got the ball as well. Is an incredible story for the United States in lane three. Never in the history of Olympic swimming has anyone gone 12 years between gold medals. He tied Gary Hall for the title in Sydney in 2000. Let's see who's going to have to come back on it. And down there in lane seven is Manadu, also looking strong. Here they come to the wall. Jones trying to fight off the rest of the field. And it's Manadu who gets gold down in lane seven. Jones. Last final of the night will take a little more than 20 seconds to complete. The men's 53. Stop ascension. Manadu in lane four, Ervin above him in lane three. Adrian 2 lanes below Manadu in lane six.
That's the best step I've ever seen Tony do. Look at that, lane number three. He was up for him, and he swims faster than anybody else. Can't he win? Manadu down.
Manadu in lane four. There's Anthony Ervin surging in lane three. Is he going to do it again? You bet.
Is familiar, right? Swimming, the meets, you know, the ritual almost of how we proceed through it from one step to the next. Even arriving here, there's a sense of ritual to it, and then you go and compete and perform, and then you come off the stage.